Hi.
Well, congratulations. Is that kind of how you expected tonight to go?
In my wildest dreams, it is. In my wildest dreams. I think I said to everyone I was going to try and knock her out with an elbow or get her an armbar. And I did. Yeah.
What are you feeling right now? Because it seems like you're holding something back, maybe.
It's just been the hardest 14 months of my life. My biggest dream was to fight at MSG. I got destroyed. I got co-main event at London, got destroyed. And I had to really dig in deep to see if I really wanted it. My coach Paul Rimmer sat me down and just said, how much do you really want to be a champion? It's going to cost that to make this weight and to achieve at this weight. And every single person online doubted me. Every person gave me hell. And that icing on the top of the cake, that performance, it's not going to shut them up, obviously, but I couldn't have done any better. It was mixed martial arts. I kicked, I elbowed, I kneed, southpaw, orthodox, takedown, ground and pound, submission win.
How did you feel in there? Did it feel different in there?
Calm. I felt calm. I felt ready. I felt like when I want to go into second gear, I will. I don't feel like I got out of first gear, if I'm being honest with you. I was a bit nervous in case I gassed. So I was like, warm up in the first round and then get to it in the second. She's still got 5 inches reach on me. She still had 6 inches on a reach. So I just had to be aware. I'm sure it was evident that I've carried power from the weight above to the weight below. And I'm just as fast at this weight as what I was. I'm just as fast as the straw weight as I was as flyweight. So there's Michaela. Michaela! Get here, love. Michaela! Come here. Michaela! She's not my mate now. You can wait with us.
Well, what does she mean to you since she's right here?
Oh, she's just one of my mates. She's a boxer. She fought some Scouse Beard. My Scouse Beard, one of my mates, Tasha Spelpo. She's a cool kid.
So can you talk to me a little bit about that one round? Did you, were there any surprises in there? Did you, have to adjust, make any adjustments or anything like that?
I was told by my coaches, just work into the round, and I think that's what I did. Like, the second I landed my overhand at the beginning, I was like, okay, this is going to be a good night for me. I was shocked with how much she took. There was a point where I hit her and she made a noise because she'd hit her eye and couldn't see, and I just took her down then because I didn't want to keep on hitting that eye. I think I went a bit soft in there. But then when I took her down, I just worked through the gears and through the motions and just done what I was supposed to do. But I think I shocked myself with how easy it was, because I've made it out to be so much harder in my head. I think because I just let go and I didn't have a specific, this is how it's going to happen, I'm going to do this, it just flowed. I kept hearing my coach Adam, 3 minutes, 2 minutes, 1 minute, and I was like, fucking hell, I'm not even out of breath here. Oh, all right. So, yeah, I think I could have ended it whenever I wanted to push on. And I said I'll end it however I wanted to end it. So I did.
And I know you and I talked on Instagram a little bit yesterday. Can you kind of talk to us a little bit about the face-off, what you were feeling in that face-off? And, some of us thought there was it.
Oh, yeah, because you said that I'd snubbed it. And I was just like, this fight was about me versus me. It wasn't about me versus my opponent. I didn't want to be drawn into something that was going to heighten my emotion and or me to react and act a bit more and be like the meatball. Like, I'm Molly now. I don't look like a meatball. I'm not walking like a meatball and I'm not talking like one anymore. I'm cool, calm and collected. And this was my moment. This is all me. I've done this. Molly McCann done this. And I didn't want to just pretend like I can't stand you, because I do like Diane. So that moment was for me. And You've never seen me shake someone's hand before the stare down. You know, I gave her the respect that she deserves. She made weight. She came. If she could have done that to me, she would. So I just, it was all about me today.
Did you speak to her at all after the fight?
I've looked for her. I think she's gone to hospital. But when I celebrated, it wasn't like a typical meatball celebration. I just hit the deck because I was overwhelmed. And I gave her a kiss on the forehead and said, I hope you're okay. And I'll go and have a look for her. I know how it feels to have to go to the hospital on a loss. It's the worst thing ever. So, and I know how it feels to lose two back to back. There's nothing worse. So my heart pours for her, but I just thank fuck it's not me today.
And what's next for you? When would you like to get back in there?
My hand's a bit sore. So I'll have that x-rayed and have a look. I'd like a little week off, go back to the gym, and then assess when works best for us. I hear July is in Manchester. I'd really like to have a go then. You know, I'm not one to call anyone out. I'm a company woman who takes any fight she's given. So let's hope that the matchmakers are fair to me stylistically and let me work through the rankings.
Thank you.
No problem.
Oh, I just wanted to ask you, like, how good does it feel? You know, you get tapped out in your last two fights, then you go do a grappling tournament, get an armbar, and then your job, the UFC, you go out there and get this armbar. Like, how does that feel? To prove to yourself, but also to shut people up.
I always said to Paul and my coaches, I'm not part of Next Gen. I'm not part of the team until I get a submission win. I'm crying on the cage floor. You're part of the team now. I think for me more, it's just being about maturing as a woman, as an athlete, as a role model, as a partner, as a family, as a friend, as a student. I think it's just growing up. And I think I've grown up in front of everyone's eyes today. I've made some mistakes. I've said some fucking stupid stuff. And I've rectified it all today in that performance. Like I said to you on Wednesday, I just feel calm. Like this week, I haven't kicked off on anyone. I haven't even gone, like, give no one death stares. I've just took it in my stride. And like I said to you, I'm living my dream. I'm living my dream being up here. And when I walked out, like, my coaches didn't even need to say nothing. It was like the changing room was weird. It was weird for me. I was like in my element because I was just flowing. But normally I'd need to hear positive affirmation or it's all right, you're going to do this, blah, blah, blah. And it was just calm. And I was like, I said to him, yeah, I don't even need a speech here. Like, I'm good. He's like, go and show the world how great you are, Molly McCann. And we did, and I could hear my mum and my fiance in the crowd, and it's just been really cool, actually, to not feel the pressure of fucking, I haven't let anyone get in here, I've just got to play.
Yeah, I mean, I guess you kind of talk about it all week, that you're not letting anybody get inside your head, so, I mean, was that mentally hard to do?
It's took me 33 years. It's took me fucking 5-6 losses in the UFC. I just think a lot of it comes down to the therapy that I've done and I've just had enough. Like, the team sat me down. Paul's like, do you love to fight or not? So that is my best place is when I'm in that octagon. That is my best place. Well, just go and have fun. Stop letting everyone else get in. And obviously, it's easier said than done. But I've really put the work into myself. I've listened diligently to everything that's been said by every coach. I haven't missed a run. I didn't miss a training session. I didn't eat less. I didn't eat more. My coach has told me what to do when I did. And then we got the best performance ever. So.
And then finally for me, this is just like a random one, but like, was it weird walking around the Apex all week night, like, with two former opponents? Like, one was a highlight knockout of yours, and then one was one of your losses that really broke your heart, right?
Yeah, it was mad. As we was getting ready, my coach Adam and Ellis was there, me and Paul was here, and I looked at the screen, it went Julius Darielenko, and I went, fucking hell. Like, I don't need to be seeing that armbar again. I just went like that. And me and Julia are cool. We're sweet. I've never spoke to Luana again. But it just goes to show MMA maths means nothing. Do you know what I mean? Styles make fights. And my style beat Luana, but my style couldn't beat Julia. Julia's style couldn't be her, but it could beat me. So we're all out here living the dream. Women pushing other women to success. So,
congrats and enjoy it.
Thanks, lad.
Did you expect Luana to beat Julia?
In my honest opinion, I expected her to be finished faster than me. So I'm wrong. I'll eat my hat. I was really expecting Julia to do great things tonight. And it just wasn't her night, unfortunately. Maybe she'll get the next one.
And are there any things that you're going to be approaching differently now as a strawweight?
Yeah, I'm not going to waste my time on anyone else. Journalism, media, TV, fans. It's when I was winning and when I was losing, I was getting the hate. So now I'm going to come back into the winning side. It's all about me. That doesn't mean I'm going to have a big ego and I'm going to be arrogant, but my reasons for winning is different. I'm not here to make people proud anymore. I'm here to do it for myself. And I think that took a lot of pressure off. And I think everyone could see that this evening.
I don't know. I know you're taking on a different mentality now, but it's been a couple of months. It's been a minute since we saw you and Patty on the same card. Both of you guys are coming off wins now. Maybe July Manchester. Is that the goal?
Listen, one of them best be for me. High noon over there. I would give anything to fight with my brother in Manchester. It's literally 30 minutes drive from our gym. I would give anything to fight with him. He's just been on FaceTime. We've just got all pictures in the back room and I put him on my phone and he was in the team pick with us. Yeah, I'd probably bring more hate on myself. We would bring more hate on ourselves fighting together, but we just bring the best out of each other. But it's great that we've both had our own moments individually. He got his moments against Tony. I've had my moments against Diane. And we've just proved that the next gen source is real.
That's awesome. And I have a couple fun ones for you real quick. There's a content creator by the name of Temptaliza TV who goes around Liverpool asking strangers what the best place in Liverpool is for chicken and can of Coke. So I want to ask you, what is the best place for a chicken and can of Coke?
Nabsy's Norris Green, you know that. Chicken and a can of Coke.
And obviously I know you're a big Everton fan. Things aren't too hot right now, so what is going on at Goodison Park right now?
Madness, lad. Madness. Well, me and Adam had the highlights on this morning, and it was 2-2, so I was like half made up that we didn't have a loss, so I was buzzing with that. And I'm going to watch the Man City game next week. So you can only imagine how I'm going to be drowned in my sorrows there. But we can't pick. We're chosen. So.
And how much longer do you think it'll take for UFC to go back to Liverpool?
It's if they want to get the checkbook out. I know the M&S Bank will have them in. I just know that it'll cost quite a bit. But when you're talking about atmosphere, when Darren Till headlines, you're seeing the atmosphere. Imagine what it'll do now with me and Patrick. And there's so many kids in our gym. And by kids, I mean young men, sorry, who are ready for the jump. We've got 5-6 lads in my fight team who are ready for the jump. So we can make it next gen versus the Wales if they want.
Obviously, Paddy's been very adamant of saying that it should be at Anfield. I know, I'm sure you might want it to be at Goodison though, right?
Well, we've got a new stadium next year, lad, Bramley Moor. Shit's all over Anfield.
Awesome. Congratulations.
Thanks, lad. My turn.
Just a couple for me. Congrats on the win. Amazing.
Thank you.
Molly, that was like a knife through butter. Were you surprised at all in that performance? Just, I know you trained, you prepared, but the way you just got the takedown, transition, and just ran through the person, steamrolled your opponent tonight.
Honestly, like, that's our system in our gym. It's what my coach makes us rinse, repeat every day. and I've never been able to consistently do it in fights because the girls were too heavy. We said at this weight I'd be a different beast, and you can see that. And now leaving today, I'll have faith in that, that it's not a one-off. They wasn't just saying it to fill lip service. It's the truth, and I am who I always believed I was, and the hard work that's led me to this moment was worth every bit of pain. It was worth every night I've cried myself to sleep. And I'm living my dream, and I've done it. Like, I could die tomorrow, and I've done it. Like, I've achieved what I've really set out to achieve, so I'm buzzing.
That's wonderful to hear from a fighter. And that, how great is it to have that, that family aspect, that love back, that you believed in them, they believed in you. You just said it, you listened to your coaches, and look at this performance.
Well, they don't chat shit, and if they're shouting at me, there's normally a reason for it. So sometimes it's hard for fighters to not be in control, and I think some people can't give in to their coaches and believe because they think they know best. Under my breath, I might mutter back because I think I know best, but ultimately, my coaches aren't saying the wrong thing. They're saying the right thing. They've been there. They've done it. They've got the T-shirt. So I keep saying it, say less, do more, head down, keep on going.
Excellent. And last for me, there was many tonight, but one of my favorite quotes, just when you said, you're not going to waste your time on anyone else. It was me versus me, you said. How amazing is it to conquer those demons on this stage?
I haven't been on my phone once today. Last night, I put a post up at Hell's Kitchen, and I said, full belly, full heart, I catches after. And I think tomorrow, I'm not going to go on today. Tomorrow, I'll have a little look, and I'll see what everyone else is saying. Because I think this sport's that fickle that everyone will probably be up my arse now because I've won. But they can stay over there. The win was for me and for my family, so we'll have our time. And I can't tell you how good it feels just to have the weight of the world off my shoulders.
Excellent. Congratulations.
Thanks, mate.
Amazing performance.
Am I done now?
Yeah. Cheers.
Thanks, lads.